Dr. Jitendra Tandir, Chemistry Department from BP Bharia Science Institute. Today, I am going to deliver a lecture on thermodynamics. In first year BSc, you studied the first law of thermodynamics. In second year, you studied the second law of thermodynamics. In third year BSc, the third law is that. Brief dynamics and thermals. Dynamic means motion. Motion means one type of energy will be converted into another type of energy. This is the called motion, one type of energy converted into another. Thermal means heat or energy. Heat is a one type of energy. You know that. Heat means one type of energy converted into another type of energy. The thermodynamics related is so many terms like systems, surroundings, boundary, and the first law of thermodynamics, second law of thermodynamics, and the third law of thermodynamics. The first law is related with conservation of energy. Conservation of energy means one type of energy change into another. It neither created or not visible. The first law is related to this equation, delta E is equal to E minus W. Delta E means change in energy. Q means heat given to the system or heat absorbed by systems. W means work done on systems. Now discuss about second law. Second law of thermodynamics about spontaneous process. Spontaneous process. In all spontaneous process, the energy also increases. Or the entropy also increases. It means in all universal process, the entropy is always increasing. The second law state about related entropy. Ds is equal to dq divided by T. This is the definition of entropy. Entropy means measure the randomness or disorderness of the systems. This is the second law. Or in third law, at absolute zero, at zero temperature, in pure crystalline substance, the entropy will be zero. Entropy is zero. It means at absolute zero temperature, in all pure crystalline substances, the entropy is zero. This is the first law, second law, and third law of thermodynamics. There are two types of properties here. One is intensive property, and second is extensive properties. Systems, there is three main systems: open system, closed systems, and isolated system. This isolated system, you cannot change the matter or heat with the surrounding. This is isolated system. Isolated. In open system, you can change or you can transfer matter or energy, both. You can transfer with surrounding. This is open system. And in closed system, you cannot transfer the matter. You can transfer only energy in this closed system. There are three types of system: isolated, open, and closed. Now, today we discuss the topic in third year BSc, paper 8. The first chapter is open thermodynamics. In open thermodynamic system, the first topic of the PYBAC paper 8, first topic is partial molar properties. Partial molar properties, or which is also known as chemical properties. created with enthalpy, entropy. From what function gives energy, all are state functions. And all are related to extensive properties. Now, G and Lewis scientists introduce the topic partial molar properties of chemical potential. Now, the property is depends on temperature, pressure, or a number of constituents present in the systems. So, all are depends on temperature, pressure, and constituents present in the system. Today, we take a consider an open system. Open system means has a temperature T, pressure P, and the constituent numbers of both constituent J. J means ghatako. Jena ghatako che J fully pranay tapman che T, pressure T, ane tena ghatako che 1, 2, 3, 4 J, ane N1, N2, MJ. Ete che badar ane numbers of mole che, numbers of mole. Jo a system ma ati alpa ferfar tha. So they gives energy che, function of G. Energy is a function of T means temperature, P means pressure, N1 means numbers of mole, N2 number of moles, Mg. This is the first equation in thermodynamics. When you read the subjects, it is necessary with writing caps. Otherwise, you cannot read, because writing practice is the best practice for thermodynamics, because all are mathematical steps. And without writing practice, you cannot remember the topic. This is my main sentence, because it is a very hard topic, and without practice, you cannot remember it. Okay, so this is the first equation. G is a function of T, P, N1, N2, dot dot dot, Nj. If there is a small change in a system, the energy will be changed partial on partial differentiation. Dg is equal to del, this is del, del G divided by del K. And this is the first, and out of all our constant, P is constant, N1 is constant, N2 is constant, dT. This is the first differentiation of T at constant P, N1, N2, and Ng. Now the second, we take dT. Del G is equal to 1 del B. Here T, here V. Now the constant is T. N1, N2, dot dot dot, Ng, AP. Now third one is N1. It means del G means del N1. Constant is P, T, N2, Nj, Dn1. As same thing, we can write del G divided by del N1 is equal to the last one, which is related to del N. Del G divided by del Ng. Last constant is P, E, N1, N2, Dng. This is the second equation of thermodynamics. you can see EP N1, N2, NG. First, respectively. Second, respectively. Third, respect to N1. Fourth one, N2. And the last one is NG. This is the partial differentiation of equation 1. Okay? This is very easy. First, you can see that AG divided by DT. Out of all our constant, T. Then the second one is P, respect to P. AG divided by DT, P, N1, N2. Dot 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 NJ. Now same thing. The third one is respect to del N1. Del N2 and then del NJ. This is very easy. You can practice with writing practice because without writing practice you cannot remind it. Okay? Now the fourth equation, you see the first and second. Here the quantity del G divided by del N1 T P N2 and NG. This is known as partial molar properties. This is known as partial molar properties. You can put G1 bar. You can write like this bar on the properties G1. Same thing if you write about N2. E, P, not write N1. It means, sorry, N1. N1 is constant. N3 dot dot dot. This is G2 right bar. All are partial molar properties. Partial molar properties is defined as the change in free energy. Even upon addition of small amount or one mole of constituent, without any change in the properties or numbers of moles or constituents, is known as partial molar properties or chemical potential. This is the change in free energy of a system during adding the one mole of substance in a large bulk of a system. There is no change in the amount of constituents. This is known as partial molar properties. This is the definition of partial molar properties. You can write G1 or bar. G1 bar, G2 bar. Or this is also related with chemical potential. You can write chemical potential mu1 or mu2. Mu is a chemical potential. It means same equation you can write that mu1 is equal to or mu is equal to g1 bar and these equations. From equation 2, you write as the equation from equation 2, we can write del g is equal to dg is equal to. Same thing, del g is equal to change equation del g divided by del T, P, N1, N2, del T. This is the first step. Now the second step is related to P, del P, T, N1, N2, del T. And now you can write with chemical potential this one. This is mu1. Mu1 is there, the whole, this one is mu1, dN1. Plus mu2 dN2. Same thing dot 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 uj dNg. This is the equation number 3. I remember the all equation. The first equation is g is a function of p, p, n1, n2, and n3. then we are the partial differentiations, dg is equal to all things, and now this is the third equation in which chemical potential is that mu1 into mu2. Now this is the third equation. After this third equation, you can see that at constant temperature and pressure, constant temperature means T is constant, and constant pressure means P is constant. At constant temperature and pressure, the equation will reduce. Reduce means go through all steps. Under X, that means dG is equal to mu1 dN1 plus mu2 dN2. Same thing, dot dot dot, equation μj dN. Here mu is chemical potential, N1 is numbers of mole, and g is molar partial properties, partial molar properties. This is equation 4. Now the four equation, first equation is g is equal to function of, g is a function of T, N1, N2. Then we derive the partial differentiation in all things respect to T. First respect to T, then second respect to P, the third one respect to N1, the fourth one respect to N2. Now dot dot dot, the last one respect to Nj. In third equation, we put the chemical potential. Chemical potential is denoted by mu. This is most thing, that chemical potential represented by mu. The partial molar properties represented by g bar. You can write g bar or g1, g2, g3 like this. Now the equation is 4. mu1 is equal to dN1 plus mu2 dN2 plus muj dN2. Now here mu1, mu2 and muj are the chemical potential. Chemical potential with respect to components 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The equation 4, if the equation 4 is integrated, then the integrated equation is there. Integrated equation, it means equation 4, the all constituents are constant. As remember that the equation last one is g is equal to n1, first dn1 respect to n1, then mu1, same thing n2, mu2, then dot dot dot, nj muj. This is the equation number 5. Here g is a partial molar properties, n1 is numbers of moles of constituent 1, mu1 is a chemical potential of constituent 1, n2 is a number of moles of constituent 2, mu2 means chemical potential of constituent 2. Same thing, nj and mj. N is a number of moles and mu is a chemical potential. This is the equation 5. The equation 5 shows that in partial molar properties, chemical potential of any constituents may regard as, it is a contribution. Plus means contributions. Contributions of numbers of moles. moves. M1, M2, M3. It means all are contributed in total volume. This is the partial molar properties or chemical potentials. Okay? How many minutes? Kitli minute hai?
20 minute. 20 minute.